N place, we are subtracted 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or and N. Now, so here, in N place, we subtract 1, we get a 6. 64 of 1 is a 6. Left, 6 square, that is a 6 into 6, that is a 36. 6 into, that is a 6 into 6 into 6, that equal to 216. Now, 64 of 4, that equal to 1296. Now, and so on, so here you have the last digit of these ones, so that is a 6, 6, 6 and 6. So, again, the last digit of 64 of n is also 6. So, therefore, so 64 of n can end with the digit 6. But so here given, 64 of n can end with the digit is 0? No. So, therefore, 64 of n cannot end with the digit 0. Okay? Right now. Next, fourth problem, explain why 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13 and 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5 are composite numbers or not? So what is a composite number? So composite number means that it is the product of two numbers. Will get a composite number. The product of two numbers will get a composite number. So what is the definition of the composite number? If a number having three or more than factors, we call it a composite number. Because now so we are given 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13 and 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5. So in this you have just here, so 7 is 1, 11 into 13 is 1 term, 13 is another term. So 13 is also we can written as 13 into 1. Now in this 13, here in this 13, so both two terms have the, these terms have the 13. 13 have the common number. So 13 will be the common. Now we will get a 7 into 11 plus 13 will be the common, we will get a plus 1. And also so here, 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5. So here also, 5 is the common number, that is due to the common. Remaining 7 into 6 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So 5 into you can return 5 into 1. So there is the remaining 1. That means plus 1. Now so here, 7 into 11 is the 77 plus 1. So 77 plus 1 is the 78. 13 into 78 is the 1014. 1014. And now so here, 5 into 1008, so 6, 7 into 6 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, 1008 plus 1. 1008 plus 1 is 1009. So 5 into 1009 is 5045. So here, 1014 is a product of two numbers. So 1014 is 14 is a composite number. So here also, 5045 is a product of two numbers. Yes, this is a product of two numbers. So therefore, it is also a composite number. So therefore, given numbers are composite numbers. Okay, na? Now fifth one is the same method. So how will you show that 17 into 11 into 2 plus 17 into 11 into 5 is a composite number? So 17 into 11 into 2 plus 17 into 11 into 5 is a composite number or not? So what is a composite number? That is a product of two numbers is a composite number. Okay, now so here, in this two terms, 17 into 11 is a common. So that is we will do the common 17 into 11. Then we will get a 2 plus and the so here remaining is a 5. So 17 into 11 is a 187. So 2 plus 5 is a 7. So 187 into 7 is a 1309. Now so here 1309 is the product of two numbers. That is 187. So therefore, 1398 composite number. 1398 composite number. So this is a product of numbers. Therefore, given number is a composite number. Okay, next sixth one is what is the last digit of 64 of 100? What is the last digit of 64 of 100? Now 64 of 100. Now so here, first of all, 64 of 100 is 6. 6 square is 36. 6 cube is 216. 64 of 4 is 1216. So here, 6 is multiplied so many times, we will get the last digit is 6. So 6 is multiplied 3 times, we will get the last digit is 6. 6 is multiplied 4 times, we will get the last digit is 6. And also 64 of 100. So 6 is multiplied by 100 times, we will get the last digit also 6. So therefore, last digit of 64 of 100 is 6. Okay? Right. Right up. So next, another concept is terminating decimal and also non-terminating recurring decimal. So every rational number we can written as terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimal. So recurring means repeating. Recurring means repeating. Every rational number we can written as terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimal. So now what is a terminating decimal? What is a terminating decimal? So in p by 2, so where 2 is not equal to 0, p is divisibility by 2. Where so here you divide the p, you will get a remainder 0. You will get a remainder 0. Then p by 2 is called the terminating decimal. P by 2 is called the terminating decimal. So what is the terminating decimal? So in p by 2, p is divides the, so q divides the p, then you will get a remainder 0. Then p by q is called the terminating decimal. Or in p by 2, p is divisible by 2, then p by 2 is called the terminating decimal. So for example, 3 by 4. So 3 is divisible by 4. So this number, so here, three, four. Now this will go to, in fourth day put 3 will come, no. So you put point, you will take 0. So now this will go to 4, 7, 29. To remainder. Already you put point here, then you will take 0. So this will go to 4, 5, 20. You will get remainder is 0. Therefore, 3 by 4 is 0.75. So it is a, you will get remainder is 0. Therefore, 3 by 4 is called a terminating decimal. And also, 1 by 2 is 0.5. It is the example for terminating decimal. 7 by 8 is 0.875. It is also example for terminating decimal. Now, another decimal is a non-terminating recurring decimal. Non-terminating recurring decimal. So, what is a non-terminating recurring decimal? So, in a decimal number, last digit or group of digits are repeating. In a decimal number, last digits or group of digits are repeated. That is, we call it a non-terminating recurring decimal. Non-terminating recurring decimal. So, for example, 1.2222. So, here, last digit is repeated. So, this is a, you will get remainder 0. So, we will not get a remainder 0, but in a quotient, last digit or group of digits are repeating. So, for example, 1.222. So, this is also can written as 1.21. Next, 2.3454545 and so on. So, here 45, that means group of digits are repeated. This is also can written as 2.3454545. So, it is also example for non-terminating repeating decimal. So 0.87555 and so on. This is also can be written 0.875. So here 5 only repeated. So this is because of a non-terminating recurring decimal. So another example is also this one is 0.1212 and so on. So this is also can be written 0.121. So every rational number can be written as in terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimal. And also terminating decimal or non-terminating recurring decimal we can also written as in the form of p by q. And in rational number, every terminating or non-terminating recurring decimal we can be written as rational number. So every terminating term or non-terminating recurring decimal can be written as a rational number. So that is a p by q. So where q is not equal to 0.